My name's Nicholas Barnett. I do irrigation is my forte, landscaping and irrigation, but my specialty is the sprinklers, the irrigation side. So drip line, sprinklers, HydroSpirals now. Repertoire. The big thing about this soil here in the desert, I think, is it's really insulating. So it's very hard for water to get through that top crust layer into underground. If you have a bubbler that's pouring water on top, it takes a long time for that to get down. So getting the water underground right away is really good, especially in the hot summer, because it stays under there. Like, you'll be blown away, like we went over there, and that ran, I think, maybe a couple of days ago, you know?
Right.
And it stays moist because it's under that layer of crust. So that alone is already a big plus why I use these more than the bubblers. And then even compared to drip line, which would be the other way to get underground, which I love drip line too, and the ways of doing that. It doesn't get the air in there. So we're big on the aeration with these, right? It's huge. Drip doesn't really give you that. I mean, I think it does suck some air into the system and get it in a little bit, but not a lot.
Not the way these can breathe.
No, not even close.
And get down into the roots.
Yeah. The area that I finished a month ago, it has been done, so I've gotten to see some results. About 60 heads there. And I mean, huge difference from when I started running the system.
Because it's not getting wasted on the surface to evaporation.
100%.
At the, what was it here, 109 sometimes?
It's gone. It's absolutely gone. And you know, things that we're aware of a lot, and something I see a lot, is, you know, we plant a Palo Verde tree. And then I'll come back 6 months later, and during a windy season, the tree has fallen over. Okay.
Yeah.
It's a big thing. And then you look and you're like, ah, coincidentally, it had a bubbler on it. So it's only watering on the top. Very hard for it to seep down. The only way you can get it to seep down, well, a common way, is people will put the tree in the center of a hole, right? So then all the water is pooling there in the trunk, which is causes a lot of rot and different problems like that, right? Anaerobic conditions. The roots don't have any reason to go deep. They're actually growing up.
Shallow, yep.
Very shallow. Roots. So the tree will fall over. So that is a huge difference too when we are encouraging. We've been on that deep watering kick for everything in the desert. I mean, that's something we've just learned, you know, is the way, you know, and people are so surprised. How should I water this tree? And I say, you're never going to believe me. And then I ask them, how long are you watering the tree? And they're like, oh, you know, I probably do it. You know, I go out there with the hose. And I'm like, dude, I am leaving the hose trickling on it. And then I go to sleep and wake up in the morning, you know, and change it. Like, sometimes I forget and it works out in my favor, but that's how I water everything now, you know? Even my little garden, my herb garden, I'm deep soaking, I'm deep watering.
That's what they want.
For short periods of time, especially in the desert.
Yeah.
Because that's how it kind of operates here.
And then let them dry out a little bit and then a deep drink again.
Exactly. Yeah, so that's been really helpful with the spirals. With the gravel in there, real camouflage. I'm loving them. I see this HydroSpiral as a part of a drip line system. That's where I would classify this, right? Part of a drip line system. So I see it as an emitter, you know, just like one of the button emitters, or maybe not quite, but a part of the emitter. So I see it as an essential part to a drip line. And to be honest with you, I see it as the best part of the drip line system. You know, it's like, this is the best emitter on the market. That's what I think. You know, that's how I'm seeing it.